Hello everyone, today we'll discuss on important current affairs for 13th August. If the content is helpful, please share, like, comment and subscribe. At the end, we'll learn a vocabulary word on daily basis. First one, what is the name of the upper stage rocket engine to be test fired by India's first private aerospace company, Skyroot Aerospace? Answer is Raman. Skyroot Aerospace, Indian aerospace startup, successfully test fired an upper stage rocket engine called Raman, India's first 100% 3D printed bipropellant liquid rocket engine injector, named after the Nobel laureate Sir C.V. Raman, and became the first private aerospace company in India to test a rocket engine developed in India. This engine can impel a satellite of 250 to 700 kilometers into the lower orbits. This engine is capable of multiple restarts, which enables the launch vehicle to insert various satellites into multiple orbits during a single mission. Skyroot Aerospace is a startup which was established in the year 2018 by former ISRO scientists Pawan Kumar Chandana and Nagabharat Daka. Next one. Who is the head of the committee formed by the central government for procurement and administration of COVID-19 vaccine? Answer is Dr. V.K. Paul. The central government has formulated an expert committee called National Expert Group on Vaccine Administration under the chairmanship of Dr. V.K. Paul, who is a member at the Niti Aayog. This panel will identify the COVID-19 vaccine that is effective in fighting against the virus and then formulate a plan for its procurement. This committee will consider the issues related to logistics of the vaccine and will prepare a strategy on inventory management, distribution and administration. Yesterday we discussed about the first registered COVID vaccine in the world. What is the name of that vaccine? It is Sputnik V. This vaccine is developed by Gamaleya Research Institute of Russia. Next one. When is International Youth Day celebrated? Answer is 12th August. International Youth Day is celebrated on 12th August every year. This day highlights the contribution of youth to the well-being of the world and their achievements. It also highlights their actions and initiatives towards the society. The theme of this year is Youth Engagement for Global Action. The theme highlights the ways in which the engagement of young people at the local, national and global levels is enriching national and multilateral institutions and processes. This day was designated by the United Nations and the first International Youth Day was observed on 12th August 2000. About United Nations, it was established in the year 1945. Current Secretary General is Antonio Guterres and its headquarters is in New York. Next one. Tribal Affairs Ministry is developing how many tribal freedom fighters museums to recognize their contribution in India's independence? Answer is 9. The Tribal Affairs Ministry is developing 9 tribal freedom fighters museums which are completely dedicated to the contributions of the tribal people in India's freedom struggle. Development of these museums will be completed by the end of 2022. These museums will showcase how tribals struggle to protect their biological and cultural diversity of the country. The announcement of these museums was made by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 15th August 2016. Do you know who is the Tribal Affairs Minister? Arjun Munda. Next one. Rahat Indori passed away recently. What was his profession? Answer is poet. Rahat Indori was a famous Urdu poet. He passed away in Indore due to cardiac arrest. His career as a poet was for a span of 50 years and he also worked as a lyricist for movies like Munna Bhai MBBS, Kareeb, Ghatak and Ishq. His original name was Rahat Qureshi, later known as Rahat Indori. He was awarded a PhD in Urdu literature from the Bhoj University of Madhya Pradesh in 1985 for his thesis titled Urdu Mein Mushaira. Next one. Which city is the first city in India to set up female icons on traffic signals? Right answer is Mumbai. Mumbai is the first city in India to have women symbols on traffic signals and signboards. Generally, we see these signs with a male icons in traffic signals, and now for the first time in India, Mumbai has set up these icons. These are installed by Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation. This change was made to highlight the gender equality in a simple way. These female signs can be seen in other countries like Australia, and now this is the first time in India. Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Chief Minister is Uddhav Thackeray and Governor is Bhagat Singh Koshyari. Next one. Which Indian origin person has been nominated for the US Vice Presidential candidate for coming elections in US? Answer is Kamala Harris. Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden has named Indian origin Senator Kamala Harris as his vice presidential candidate. By this, Joe Biden made history by selecting the first black woman to compete on a major party's presidential ticket. Kamala Harris is currently the US Senator from California. If elected, Kamala Harris would be the first ever woman to be the Vice President of the United States and the first ever Indian American and African Vice President of the country. Kamala Harris is the daughter of an Indian mother and a Jamaican father. She was also the first female African American and Indian origin to become California's Attorney General. Harris became the first Indian origin and second African American woman to join the Senate, winning the California seat. About United States, its capital is Washington DC and its currency is United States dollar. Next one. Who is the author of the book titled Our Only Home, A Climate Appeal to the World? Answer is Dalai Lama. Dalai Lama is the author of the book Our Only Home, A Climate Appeal to the World. Who is Dalai Lama? He is a Tibetan spiritual leader. The book appeals to the political decision makers to fight against the ignorance on the issue of climate change and urges people to stand up for a different climate-friendly world and asks the younger generation to assert their right to regain its future. This book is set to release in November. Next one. Lok Sabha has started a beginner level course for the officials and the staff in which language recently? Answer is French. Lok Sabha has started a beginner level course in French for the officials and staff of the Lok Sabha Secretariat at the Parliament House. This course was launched with a view that languages brings people together and helps improve their efficiency and skill. In the near future, courses in German, Spanish, Russian and other important world languages would also be organized. This course was launched by the Lok Sabha Speaker. Do you remember who is the Lok Sabha Speaker? Om Birla. Om Birla is the Lok Sabha Speaker. Next one. How many police personnel were awarded Union Home Minister's Medal for Excellence in Investigation for 2020? Answer is 121. The Union Home Minister's Medal for Excellence in Investigation for 2020 has been awarded to 121 police personnel. The medal was constituted in 2018 with the objective to promote high professional standards of investigation of crime and to recognize such excellence in investigation by investigating officers. Among the personnel receiving these awards, 15 are from Central Bureau of Investigation, 10 each are from Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra Police, 8 are from Uttar Pradesh Police and 7 each are from Kerala and West Bengal Police. The remaining are from other states and union territories. These awards include 21 women police officers as well. Remember, Union Home Minister is Amit Shah. Now we'll learn the vocabulary word for today. Today's word is aggravates. It means make worse or more serious. Example is unscientific cutting of slopes into hills aggravates the risk of soil erosion. These are the important current affairs for 13th August. If the content is helpful, please share, like, comment and subscribe. Thank you.